Happy Friday, weirdos! Welcome to the Darren Marlar Radio Show. And, well, I call you weirdos, and I mean that in the utmost respect. It's all out of love. We do a lot of weird stuff here on the show. Also, I'm known for my daily dose of weird news and also my my scary story show called Weird Darkness. So my fans just started calling themselves weirdos. And, well, hopefully I would consider you fans slash friends as well. So I say good hello to you, weirdos. Coming up on today's show, a British woman's bulging wig? Well, it did not fool customs agents in Norway who realized she wasn't just having a bad hair day. That's our Brain on Drugs story coming up a little bit later on. He calls himself an artist, but Michael Fernandez, his exhibit in Halifax, Nova Scotia, it did have a few people scratching their heads. We'll tell you why. If the upcoming solar eclipse on August 21st, which is this coming Monday, if that doesn't work into your schedule, well, you do have another one coming up, and I'll tell you when that is. What would you do if you found a bullet in the middle of the street? Okay, now, what would you do if you wanted to be featured in today's moment of duh? That story's on the way. What happens when internet social justice warriors get it wrong when they accuse you of racism? I have a totally outrageous story about that coming up on a little bit later on as well. We'll do a question impossible. I've got a couple of useless facts for you. A preacher in Africa claims to be able to walk on water like Jesus. We got our weird holidays coming up next. I'm Darren Marlar. If you missed any shows in the past, you can catch up with them at DarrenOnTheAir.com. It's D-A-R-R-E-N, DarrenOnTheAir.com. Well, a study says that better sleep, it's as beneficial as winning the lottery. Well, I guess that depends on your definition of beneficial. I seriously doubt MasterCard's going to accept my sleeping in as this month's minimum payment. Did you know that your body constantly refreshes itself? According to an NPR report, each body part has its own very distinct lifespan. The lining of your stomach, for example, it's constantly under assault by digestive acid, so it's renewed every few days. Your bones, they're refreshed about once every 10 years. So you can literally commit a crime now and then a decade from now claim, "Well, that wasn't me." If you like to hear scary stories, I have something that I do on my website called Weird Darkness, and you can find that at DarrenOnTheAir.com. Now let's take a look at today's weird, wacky, strange, zany, odd, bizarre, quirky, unusual holidays. Today's Friday, August 18th. We have 128 shopping days until Christmas. Only one holiday on the list today. It's Bad Poetry Day. Today's the day to write a really terrible poem and then send it to your high school English teacher. Ah, yes, Mrs. Adams. I remember her so well. I did this last year, and this is what I wrote to her. I said, "Roses are red, violets are blue. I hated your class, and so did everybody else."
I think that I shall never see a poem lovely as a tree.
A new poll finds that 67% of gamers will miss sleep in order to continue playing video games. Now, that might sound terrible, we might look down upon them for that, but come on, let's face it. An even greater percentage of us, we stay up late because we can't walk away from Facebook.
I woke up this morning, my Facebook friends were gone. My profile seemed empty, I was sad and forlorn. No more friend suggestions or things I might like. All my so-called friends told me to take a hike. Well, I might go back to my space. I got nothing more to lose, 'cause I'm down to zero friends. I got the lonesome Facebook blues.
Coming up, a preacher in Africa claims to be able to walk on water like Jesus. Hey there, I'm Darren Marlar, and if you need to catch some shows from the past, you can find them in my free mobile app. Just do a search for Marlar House in your phone app store, or if it's even easier, just click the mobile app tab at darrenontheair.com. Got a soul glow for you today, and Justin Joneman, he's never played in a football game in 4 years with the University of Minnesota football team. But, well, that doesn't mean he hasn't made an impact there. The Gophers' backup kicker, he has dedicated himself to helping kids in need as a volunteer at Masonic Children's Hospital in Minneapolis. And it's not gone unnoticed by his teammates and coaches. He may never have played a single game of football, but Juneman, 23 years old, was just recently surprised with a full-ride football scholarship for his final season. How great is that? If you want to watch this inspiring video, and it's worth it just to see the reaction on his mom's face when she sees this happen. You can watch the video in my blog right now at darrenontheair.com. Darren is spelled D-A-R-R-E-N. Just like
useless fact.
For the first time, astronomers say they have found a planet outside our solar system that could potentially sustain life. The new discovery has Earth-like temperatures and it might even have water. Now, in galactic terms, it's relatively close, a mere 120 trillion miles away, orbiting a red dwarf star. An astronomer on the European team that found the planet calls it a nice discovery, but adds we still have a lot of questions. Like, how soon can we send Amy Schumer there? If you want to like me, poke me, tweet me, follow me, stalk me, you can find links to all of my social media at darrenontheair.com. Darren is D-A-R-R-E-N, darrenontheair.com. Well, in Libreville, Gabon, Africa, evangelist preacher Frank Cabell, he announced to his congregation that he had a revelation that if he had enough faith, he could walk on water like Jesus. So he took all of his congregation to the beach, saying that he would walk across the Como Estuary, which takes 20 minutes to cross by boat. Well, a witness said he walked into the water, which soon passed over his head. All right, so you know, this has nothing to do with having enough faith. This has everything to do, though, with breaking God's laws. One of those laws is gravity. Today's question, impossible. In the movie Jurassic Park, how many minutes of special effects were there in the film? Again, in the movie Jurassic Park, the first one, how many minutes of special effects were there? I'll have the answer for you later on in the show. If you'd like a few laughs after the show, you can check out my Daily Dose of Weird News. I have a new episode every day at darrenontheair.com. It's today's birthday wrap-up for Friday, August 18th, from The Cosby Show, Malcolm and Eddie, Jeremiah, listen up, actor Malcolm Jamal Warner is 47 today. From the movie Robin Hood, also The Contender, and now on TV's Mr. Robot, Christian Slater is 48. From Fight Club, Primal Fear, The Italian Job, Kingdom of Heaven, The Incredible Hulk, actor Edward Norton is 48 today. From 12 Monkeys and Last of the Mohicans, Madeline Stowe, she's celebrating birthday 59 today. Comedian and actor Dennis Leary from The Thomas Crown Affair, The Ref, TV's Rescue Me, he's 60 today. Comedian Elaine Boozler, 65, from Roseanne, also the boss in Mr. Mom. Comedian and actor Martin Mull is 74. And from The Horse Whisperer, An Unfinished Life, Spy Games, Captain America Winter Soldier, actor Robert Redford is 80. I'm Darren Marlar. Welcome to the show, weirdos. Well, if you are angry at him for leaving dirty dishes in the sink, say so. If you're upset with her for ignoring you at the end of a long day, speak up about it. Holding it in with the idea of not starting an argument, that is the fastest way to kill your marriage. Why? Well, it creates emotional distance. The Reverend David Code, an Episcopal priest, family coach, and also the author of To Raise Happy Kids, Put Your Marriage First, he says couples today are quick to suppress the urge to argue with one another. But just because you seldom argue, that doesn't mean your marriage is strong. The real silent killer of marriage is distancing yourself from your partner, he writes. Code insists that couples should worry more about their flight response, which that's the instinct to avoid your partner, than their fight response, which is the instinct to argue it out verbally. Hey, if you want to learn a little bit more about this, maybe get that book from Reverend Code. You can find a link to that in my blog right now at darrenontheair.com. That's D-A-R-R-E-N, darrenontheair.com. Well, what happens when internet social justice warriors get it wrong when they accuse you of racism? Well, I got a totally outrageous story coming up about that. I'm Darren Marlar, and as children return to school, a lot of parents, they're deciding what price, if any, is appropriate, or excuse me, what prize, that is appropriate to offer when kids get good grades. Now, the adults who promise money, gifts, or privileges, they say that their children study harder when those incentives are on the table. But, you know, I don't know about that. I mean, I got that as a kid, so I mean, I liked it when I was a child. But how is this preparing our kids for the real world if you give them money or other prizes if they do well in school? I mean, that's not how the world works. Once you graduate, you're not rewarded for doing well so much as you are threatened with termination if you don't do well.
I talk too much in health class, in mathematics too. So when it came to finals, I didn't have a clue. But the D I got in science, it came as quite a shock. For my report on minerals, I slept just like a rock. I don't know when Columbus sailed the ocean blue. Now was it in the summer of 1942? I never did my homework or opened up a book. So how was I to know what Mount Vesuvius should? The thing that I fear goes end of the year, report card day blue. I've got the thing that I fear goes end of the year, report card day blue.
Well, look at that. I got a B in PE.
What would you do if you found a bullet in the middle of the street? Okay, now, what would you do if you wanted to be featured in our Moment of Duh today? That story is on the way. I'm Darren Marlar, and if you'd like to drop me an email, I'd love to hear from you. You can do that at darrenontheair.com. So what happens when internet social justice warriors get it wrong when they accuse you of racism?
What time is it, boys and girls?
Of course, there are internet sleuths working hard to publicly identify and shame those white nationalists, neo-Nazis, and others who attended last weekend's Unite the Right rally in Virginia. And while the act itself might have some merit, what happens when they get it wrong? Well, talk to Kyle Quinn. He spent last Friday going to a museum and dinner with his wife in Arkansas, over 1,000 miles away from Charlottesville. Nevertheless, he was incorrectly identified as one of the men who stormed the University of Virginia campus with torches. And as a result, he has been harassed on social media, his home and address was made public. As threats poured in, he and his wife were forced to stay at a co-worker's home. Scary stuff.
Totally outrageous!
Totally outrageous!
Well, the upcoming solar eclipse, this coming Monday, August 21st, if that doesn't work into your schedule, you do have another one coming up in 2024. The next total solar eclipse in the Americas is April 8, 2024. Totality first touches Mexico, and then it enters the United States at Texas, cuts a diagonal to Maine, and visits the Maritime provinces of Canada. If that's not going to work for you, maybe you ought to plan for the one that's coming up this Monday then. Hey, I'm Darren Marlar. If you'd like to keep up with everything I do, you can sign up for my newsletter. It's the Marlar Sheet. You can sign up for it free at DarrenOnTheAir.com. So what would you do if you found a bullet in the middle of the street? Well, now think about what you'd do if you wanted to be featured in today's moment of duh. A North Philadelphia 14-year-old, he found a bullet on the street and he wanted to see what would happen if he held it over an open flame on the stove. Well, you might be wondering what the odds are that the one person in the world who didn't know what would happen when you cook a bullet would find one, but it happened. The bullet exploded, hitting the boy in the chest and face. Luckily, the injuries were not as serious as they could have been, and he was treated and released.
Duh.
Attention, everyone. This is
the Darren Marlar Radio Show.
I'm Darren Marlar. If you'd like to get social with me, you can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Minds.com, LinkedIn, Instagram. I got links to all of my social media at DarrenOnTheAir.com. That's D-A-R-R-E-N, DarrenOnTheAir.com. So, what is the most popular American meal? Well, the most popular American meal, it's not hamburgers, it's not hot dogs, chicken, or spaghetti, it's leftovers. According to a study by the Food Marketing Institute, 58% of Americans are having leftovers for dinner on any given night, including tonight on a Friday. With the tough economy, people are eating out less these days, two-thirds of Americans are buying less fancy foods, and 60% are buying store brands. At least home cooking is healthier than going out to eat, according to 39% of the study participants. Another 53%, they think that they're now eating healthier. 41% of us claim to be very concerned about the nutritional value of what we eat. So if you're looking, by the way, for a few great recipe ideas for your leftovers, I did find a couple of resources you might like, a couple of cookbooks for leftovers, and I put a link to those in my blog if you want to check them out. You can find that at DarrenOnTheAir.com. Well, he calls himself an artist, but Michael Fernandez's exhibit in Halifax, Nova Scotia, it had a few people scratching their heads. I'll tell you why coming up here in just a bit. I just heard yesterday the Hunger Games and Twilight movie series, they're getting their own theme parks in South Korea. Yeah, a Twilight theme park. How is that not literally going to suck?
Stop it, you're scaring me.
The Darren Marlar Radio Show.
That is the word on the street.
Sign up to get Darren's newsletter on his website at DarrenMarlar.com.
While the average American household gets 189 TV channels, we watch only about 17 of those channels. In fact, it seems like 17 channels, that's about our limit. Almost a decade ago, when the typical American household received 129 channels, 60 fewer than today, we were still only watching about 17 channels. But you're paying for 189 channels, so it all balances out.
Cable TV has a channel that's right for you and your needs, with several new channels such as the Time Channel.
Okay, now we have 724, and we're about 11 seconds away from 725.
The Stapling Channel.
I'm going to hold your paper straight, squeeze. Very good. Now get another one.
The Sanding Channel.
Always move with the grain. See, you're going against the grain there. Come on back over here.
And the Pope Channel. Call your cable company now and say, I want cable TV. Brought to you by Turner's Television and your local cable company.
If you missed any part of today's show or any past shows, well, you can find them right now at DarrenOnTheAir.com. That's D-A-R-R-E-N, DarrenOnTheAir.com. A British woman's bulging wig? Well, it did not fool customs agents in Norway. They realized she was not having a bad hair day either. That's our Brain on Drugs story coming up next. He calls himself an artist, but Michael Fernandez's exhibit in Halifax, Nova Scotia, well, it has a few people scratching their heads. His big artistic statement was nothing more than a regular banana perched on a gallery's windowsill. Well, nevertheless, Michael's original price tag was $15,000. Well, he later dropped the price to $2,500. Actually, Michael, it wasn't even the same banana. He changed bananas every day, eating the old ones, and then placed progressively greener ones out to demonstrate the banana's transitoriness. But the kicker here, he actually had two different collectors place holds on his work, requiring the gallery's co-owner, Victoria Page, to call them and make sure that they knew what they were getting. She told them, "It's a banana. You understand, it's a banana.
It must be true, cause I heard it on the radio. It must be true, it must be true."
Today's question, impossible. In the movie Jurassic Park, how many minutes of special effects were there? You know, that's the computer blue screen, the chroma key, etc. How many minutes of special effects were there in the movie Jurassic Park? It's hard to believe, but it only had 6 minutes of special effects. Only 6 minutes. And the dinosaurs themselves only had 13 minutes of screen time for the first Jurassic Park. It's hard to believe when you think back on it, but it's true. In comparison, by the way, it only had 6 minutes of special effects for Jurassic Park. Now the movie Independence Day, that had 50 minutes of special effects.
This is your Brain on Drugs.
A British woman's bulging wig? It did not fool customs agents in Norway, who realized she wasn't just having a bad hair day. The wig was concealing more than 2 pounds of cocaine glued to her head. Customs agents detained her on suspicion of cocaine smuggling. The bag of cocaine was glued so firmly to the woman's real hair that police reportedly had to take her to a local hospital to have it removed. The court ordered the woman held pending a formal indictment and trial.
This is your Brain on Drugs. Any questions?
And now another useless fact.
An annual survey by HR company Mercer reveals that Baghdad is the worst place on Earth to live, although Detroit is planning to appeal. Hey, if you like scary stories, I have them on a regular basis on my website, and you can listen to them anytime at DarrenOnTheAir.com. Well, I got some bad news for you parents. Too much tablet time, it might be slowing speech development in your young children. Pediatricians at the Hospital for Sick Children in Canada, who examined the effect of screen time on 900 children between 6 months and 2 years old, they found a 49% increased risk of delayed speech for every additional 30 minutes spent using a touch screen. While previous studies have reported negative effects associated with screen time, including sleeping problems, the research presented at the annual meeting of the Pediatric Academic Societies, it was the first to establish a link between handheld devices and expressive language delay. Team leader Dr. Catherine Birkin says in a news release that all screen time for children under 18 months, it should be discouraged. A suggested echoed by the AAP, actually. And that even goes for apps that are marketed as educational. One expert tells Time magazine that the littlest ones, they can't understand the connection between what they see on the screen and what they see in the real world.
This is it. Their show's funny. I gotta try that more often.
The Darren Marlar Radio Show.
So the day begins.
Thanks for joining me on the show today, Weirdos. I hope you had a great day with me. I know I had a blast. If you did miss any part of today's show, well, I will have it up on my website for you to listen to. You can find the podcast at DarrenOnTheAir.com. Or you can look for it in your phone app store. I actually have my mobile app, which you can search for Marlar House. That's M-A-R-L-A-R. I'm going to leave you today with this thought, which is just so exciting. I got some news yesterday. Beginning this coming Monday, the Darren Marlar Radio Show is going to be syndicated. Yes! Isn't that awesome? We're going to be broadcasting live along our nation's southern border to discourage illegal aliens from crossing.
Good night, ladies.
Good night, sir.
Hit it, sweetheart.
That's all, folks.